It's been a year, Daddy. I really, really miss you. Mommy says you're safe now in a beautiful place called heaven.
He was born Laurie Clifford Lampshire to parents Wilma and Cliff at Mary Hospital in Denver, November 8, 1940. But he would become known to everyone who knew him, and some who didn't, as Lawrence of Lakewood, or later, Lawrence of Florence. Yep, that's him. Although he preferred the title Sir Lawrence. But to us, he was Dad. Dad always said he was born to raise hell. He even got a tattoo saying so. Hell, some of his old pictures look like mugshots. Then there are those that show his charisma and charm came at a young age. He grew up in Denver with his older sister Jackie. Believe me, a character in her own right. They used to have to pull Jackie out of class in grade school so she could help teach Dad to skip. After all, he crawled backwards long before he did forward, so believe it or not, he made it on the basketball team. Okay, they didn't allow him to play because he couldn't dribble, and if he turned one way, he had to reverse it and turn the other way too. So they made him captain. Dad graduated from South High School. Little did he know the love of his life would graduate there 5 years later. Bobby Moritz, our mom. They first met at the old Galaxy Bar on Alameda. Dad said from the very beginning, "I'm gonna marry her." Their first date was Memorial Day weekend, 1964. He definitely had found his perfect match, and it didn't take him long to propose. But a bartender at the Bonnie Bray Tavern told Mom's dad, "Don't you let her marry him. He didn't even graduate from high school." Dad was so mad, he grabbed his high school diploma and marched it over to show Granddad. It was the beginning of a lifelong friendship. Mom and Dad got married just 5 months after they met, on Dad's birthday. That was so he'd never forget their anniversary. And Mom makes sure to point out, but we didn't have to get married. A year and a half later, in 1966, came Troy. Troy Allen. Mom always swore he was conceived during Cheyenne Frontier days. I know, probably too much information, yet just a little tidbit that probably explains a lot. Mom used to make all of Troy's clothes, his cowboy outfit and sailor suit. Always kept him looking just as dapper as Dad. When Mom and Dad went fishing, they'd put Troy in the boat, give him his pacifier just to keep him quiet. Dad used to call Troy Little Scheistrick. That's German for little shit. Grammy used to call Dad that. And Troy was, and is, our father's son. Dad taught him early on how to woo the girls, and Troy made Dad proud. In the end, it paid off big. Then in 1968, I came. Carrie Lynn, Daddy's little girl. Their pride and joy. Just kidding, Troy. Dad had to put locks on my bedroom door really high out of Troy's reach because he loved to sneak in my bedroom and crawl into my crib to play with me. What I remember most when I was little was just how much I loved to sit on Dad's lap. I did find this Father of the Year award from 1978 for being the best dad ever, for helping solve problems, punishing me for the things I did wrong, buying food for me, and keeping me under a nice shelter. And it had a hammer and a nail drawn on it. And Dad was always there pointing that camera. Again, probably explains a lot.
With News Channel 21 on Fox.
It's still a little bit scary. I want you to know I'll be okay now, Daddy. You can let go.
And I am my father's daughter. Yeah, the faces. Dad was a man of many. We've all seen them. Some have even tried to mimic them, but couldn't even come close. And that's because Dad would go to great lengths to get you to laugh. One face in particular even landed him in the paper. He was so proud of that. Mom said to the paper, "Ugly, isn't he?" But it wasn't the only time he was in the paper. This article titled, "I Cannot Tell a Lie," explains how our next door neighbor called police after Dad not only cut down his tree, but left the debris in his yard. Dad told police, yes, he did it. The property was an eyesore and the tree was damaging our fence. The article explains that the neighbor told police if Dad would just clean it up, he wouldn't push the issue. Dad refused. That's because Dad took great pride in his yard, keeping it precisely manicured and forever competing with High Ingles' yard across the street. I'm not even sure High ever even knew that. Undoubtedly, he got it from his stepdad and our grandpa, Don Nickel, seen here grooming Troy, and it was an obsession that crossed over to winter too. I remember going out to shovel a walk one year and Dad stopped me because my shovel lines weren't straight enough. Oh, and he hated that High had a snowblower. After they sold the house, he transferred the energy to Troy's yard. Our house was always the gathering place. Everyone looked forward to Mom and Dad's parties. There was always dancing, party games to be played, and liquor to be drank. Sometimes too much. Yeah, that's Dad, in all his glory. And Walt Kaska enjoying it just a little too much. And there's Mom, and Walt, of course. But the party always went on, and the bathroom always got just a little more crowded. But even Walt wasn't immune. That's him underneath our kitchen table. And the parties at our house passed on to our generation, with, and sometimes without, Mom and Dad's knowledge. Oh, you know you were there. And they often ended in a similar manner to generations past. But it was always more fun when Dad was there, the life of the party. The annual Christmas Eve party was a big hit every year. Our friends would leave their families to join ours to be entertained by Dad. He loved charades and Pictionary. He thought he was so good at it. That's Dad's drawing. It's supposed to be a rat. Yeah. Christmas was big when we were little, too. All the family from all sides would gather at our house, and us kids would fill the shower with wrapping paper and play in it. And like Mom, Mutter was always the practical joker, usually at Dad's expense. One year he even got a cement block. It had money in the middle, though. But Mom and Dad always looked forward to Halloween. Again, always a big party at our house. That's Dad in the polka dot dress. Recognize the dancing? They loved to dress up. Their costumes? Always creative. But not necessarily politically correct. And for some reason, Dad always found something to hang between his legs, even for Christmas. But if there's one thing our dad instilled in us, it was a love for the outdoors. Our childhood summers were spent camping all over Colorado, swimming and fishing, and yes, bathing in the most spectacular of lakes. Of course, one, Sweetwater, to this day holds a special place in our hearts. Dad even asked that his ashes be spread there, and I have no doubt that every summer the owners, Larry and Jane Gay, issued the order to their boys and the staff, batten down the hatches, here come the Lampshires. Dad and his antics became somewhat of a legend at Sweetwater, like when he had Kelly cast out his fishing pole, then bring it to him, all the way across the dirt road and up over the deck and into the bar. He sat there with his pole and a pan of fish next to him, so people coming in thought he had caught them right at the bar. Classic Dad. Like a lot of friends, the Gays became like family, and helped surprise Mom and Dad in Arizona decades later for their 40th anniversary. First Walt and Lois came out, then us kids and the grandkids. God, we thought both of them were gonna have a heart attack. I think that's where Dad found his most joy later on, the grandkids. First came Brittany Marie, then Heaven Joelle, and finally Dalton Robert. And just like us kids, each one is clearly a product of their grandpa.
He could tell by the moon when the fish would bite. Seems there was nothing that he didn't know. And as a kid I believed, 'cause Grandpa told me so.
Their accomplishments just tickled Dad. He'd light up and head to the bar to brag. Brittany and Heaven's graduations, Dalton's wrestling and his epic hunt. And when Heaven and Brittany filled his sunblock with mayonnaise for April Fool's and he smeared it all over himself. He baked for an hour before figuring it out. Oh, he was so proud. And while he did miss Heaven's college graduation, we knew he was there. Mom and I said those were Dad's tears of joy. And just the same, Brittany's fiance Chris had and has Dad's blessing, and we know he'll be there for their big day too. Dad lived a full life. He had a lifelong love affair with my mother and a lifelong love affair with cigarettes and beer. He left behind a lot of friends who loved every hair on his peaked little head. We left with him and we laughed at him, which was exactly how he liked it. The man who knew no strangers and woke up better looking each day. He was a force of nature. He said life is made for you to live. The best love is the love that you give. There'll be times when you wanna hold on, but you gotta let go. And I live by those words, 'cause Grandpa told me so. The only regret? Dad always wanted to make it to 50 years of marriage and go back to the Bonnie Bray Tavern with my mom, us kids, and the grandkids, just to show them they made it. He died just short of their 49th. But when he got there, I'm sure God said to him, "Welcome. You have a lot of friends who have been saving a seat just for you." The bar's that way. Grandpa told me
so. I miss you, Daddy.